There's a real myth about as soon as you're dead, your value of your work goes up a lot of degrees. And the sad fact is, when you're gone and you're out of circulation, your work is forgotten and it's devalued. It's only if you're very famous that it raises in value. My one wish that at least some of my pieces of work are valued, you know, not just monetarily, but as pieces of good painting. So I hope I'm a good painter. I certainly know when I've done a good painting. You know, I'm not going to say, well, it's not bad, you know, hope you like it. It was intuitive, I think. I mean, that's what I was good at, you know. As soon as I could hold a pencil, I drew, like most kids do, you know, and sadly most kids get that knocked out of them. You must do your maths homework, you know, you must get a proper job, you know. The idea that you went to art school to become an artist was pretty much was really aiming high. So it's been a long journey, really, you know. I suppose you could call me an artist now, but it's taken, I'm 63 now, so it didn't start till my mid-50s, really, in a very serious way. I mean, I've been described as being an artist. I prefer to call myself a painter. It's a great compliment to be called an artist, I think. Somebody like Lucian Freud was an artist because that's all he did. I have to teach to make ends meet. So when people call me an artist, I get it, and I don't want to complicate my response to being an artist, but in reality, I'm a painter. I started teaching art about 17 years ago. It's a lovely group, and that's become a labour of love, really. The hardest thing about teaching beginner people to paint portraits is to get them to stop colouring in. But where it all goes pear-shaped to a lot of people, they start with a detail and colour around it, you know. It should be the other way around. I always say, you know, if you're building a house, you start with a mucky trench and then you put a nice brickwork on. You don't do it the other way around. How I would build up a portrait is building up the structure of the face. Not just being precious about eyes, nose and mouth. The middle of the painting's the hardest spot. It's so easy to start a painting, it's easy to finish it. In the middle is when you want to chuck it away. So getting in the zone is really important when you're halfway through. People think that artists are just very fey and very lazy. There is a lot of thinking time, and you can't, it's not like being on an assembly line. You've got to be passionate about what you're going to paint, or you've got to be fired up. It's no good just painting for the sake of it. I suppose the best piece of advice I had in becoming a painter was to be original. So even to the extent of if I'm working from a photo, at some point that has to be put in a drawer. So you carry on working from your memory or from your sketchbook, and you're not governed by a photo or a copy of anything. It's always nice to sell a piece of work. Obviously, they're the part with a lot of money just because you're a nice bloke or a nice lady, but they're going to buy it for the work. But there is this sort of interaction where they are buying into you. I suppose art has taken over my life. It's all consuming, really.